fresh like I just got a contract.
Fresh like LeBron finished this season averaging 10.2 assists. He is now one of a few players to actually, you know, go out there and be able to lead the league in scoring as well as in assists. So what are your thoughts? Where does this season rank for you all in terms of LeBron? How do you feel about this season for LeBron as a whole?
I mean, for me, the season of LeBron is about LeBron as a person. And it's hard to separate what he's done this year as a human being and also as a player, both of which have been outstanding and I think pillars of what a modern NBA athlete and any athlete and human should strive to. He was asked to be a full-time point guard this year and came in with double-digit assists. Everything that man has been asked to do, sacrifices he's been asked to make, he has done. He's done it happily. He's gotten along with the coach. He's gotten along with his players. I think this is one of LeBron James' greatest seasons as a player and as a team player, despite distractions coming in, despite a new coach coming in. I could not be more impressed with what LeBron James has done as an athlete while doing the amazing things he's doing as a person. I think watching him play is like watching, it's like unlike anything else to see his court vision as somebody his stature who looks like he should be an NFL tight end. He has no business doing what he does at his size. I cannot say enough about LeBron James this year. And I think, and I probably get some flack for this, but I still think that he is the NBA MVP this year.
He's not, but Pavi, go ahead, continue. He's not, John.
As far as
the man is averaging, Giannis is averaging 30-13-5 with literally like a top 10 efficiency rating in NBA history. I love don't get me wrong, I love the LeBron narrative.
Look what he had to do. That's all it is. Point guard.
He has Anthony Davis. Is Anthony Davis not a top 5 player in the NBA? Does Giannis have another top 5 player on his team?
Yeah, Giannis, hold on, stop. Giannis does have a man I don't know if he
fits. A man that you told me would not average 24 in the playoffs last year.
Listen. That don't matter. Case for the point is, I don't know if he finished it, but he was at 50-40-90, and only 5 people in the history of basketball, he on the list with Larry Bird, Dirk Nowitzki, and Steph Curry. I'm just saying, he did have that. You could make an argument if you wanted to that Chris Middleton is having a top 10 season in the league.
He didn't finish 50-40-90. He was close, but he didn't finish it. And no, he's not having a top top what?
Top 10. 10. Man, arguably.
Look, I know you don't do drugs, but you
efficiency wise,
good.
No, but look.
Anthony Davis, Chris Middleton.
But as far as where it ranks, I mean, LeBron played what 17 years, so I'm not about to literally sit here and try to rank LeBron's season.
Best season to me.
I'm not about to sit here and literally try to rank literally every single season that he's ever had. That's like just entirely impossible. And even still, 13 best season for LeBron. LeBron's had a lot of incredible seasons. They've been MVP candidate for like all of them seasons, so that's not a terrible thing to say. But as far as just enjoyable seasons, it's been one of the most enjoyable seasons I've ever like Bron's highlight tape this year is crazy. He's dunked on people. He's made, you know, great passes. He's pulled up from half court. He's done it in a Lakers jersey. He's been a model citizen. You know, even people talk about, like, I've even seen LeBron run plays this year. I've literally seen LeBron allow himself to be used in sets this season. And I think that people, you know, always, well, oh, he going to run up with Frank Vogel. He hasn't done that. Like you said, he's been a model citizen. He could have easily, I haven't seen him really throw teammates under the bus this season. Like I've seen him do sometimes in past years. So, I remember when he did it with Kyrie. When I think Kyrie had like 0 assists. He was like, that's never going to happen again. Something like that. Like I've seen him do that with other people and he hasn't done that this season. Now you can say because he's older and he want to keep AD. All these things may be true. Maybe he's learned from other situations that happened with, you know, other players. Maybe learn from the Kyrie situation. I don't know. But for me, especially when you look at, you know, the things that he had to deal with off the court this season, which are kind of like unprecedented and like nobody prepares you to deal with some of the things off the court that he had to deal with this year. We ain't got to get into him, but he had to deal with a lot of stuff off the court this year that I think he has to be commended for.
We have to stop. All right, man.
But
Kobe's passing affected everybody. I hate how we all – No, because LeBron was the only one that had to deal
that's
with
not what we that's fast. Literally that's literally you like you don't know like no, no like you literally no, you literally know like, you literally
had to deal with so much no. They all did. We you all did. They all you did.
Literally, you literally took what I said here and then drew a comparison way over here. Me because, saying that no, because listen, no, but he was in a unique position. For one, he did break his record literally like 14 hours before. Also, you know, everybody stopped. You know, everybody literally wants to hear from LeBron for whatever reason, want to hear from LeBron James. He has to be the person at the first home game to get up there and speak and make a speech. I'm just saying that things that, you know, him as a leader of that basketball team, of the Lakers in that situation, had to deal with in that situation. I think he handled the situation as best as you could possibly handle the situation.
And I think they were all affected.
I'm not saying that they did it. I'm not affected more than that. That's not what I said. I just said that he handled the situation.
I just said that he. A lot of people have created that narrative, which I
know. I'm just saying that you, as the leader of the Lakers, as LeBron James in that jersey, when that happens, people want to hear from you. People want to know what you're going to say. You have to be the guy that, you know, the first game at Staples back, you got to be the one to go up there and talk. It has to be you. You have to learn how to, you know, navigate through that system, through that period somehow, whatever. I don't know. But I just think that for me, it was one of the most enjoyable seasons watching LeBron James. You know, even me being able to go to Lakers game this year and go watch LeBron James. It's one of the most enjoyable. Probably, I would say.
I've never seen LeBron in person. Honestly, I still have no desire to see LeBron.
Probably, I would say
I would say the
last year in Cleveland was probably the most fun I've had watching LeBron play. Then I would probably say maybe the second year after they lost. Second year in Miami, and then I'll probably maybe say the first year in Cleveland was some of the most fun I've ever had watching LeBron James. So this year is up there for me as far as fun.
Fresh like I got a contract. Moving through the city, we be going. Roller that you pulling, now you know it. Fresher than a mass contract.